Well, today we are at the Bradford Research Farm and we're looking at a solar greenhouse. And you may be thinking, aren't all greenhouses solar? Well, yes, but this was a little bit different. It's for this solar greenhouse, we want a 2-to-1-to-1 ratio. 2 meaning the length and 1 meaning the width and also the height. So in this case, we have 24 feet long by 12 feet tall by 12 feet wide. And the reason we do this is we have a very passive heat source and we can't get too far from a heat source to the plants. So we want to keep that in mind. We also want to face due south because we want to take advantage of this in the winter time when our sun is in the southern sky. So we're facing due south, and the big question then is, well, what slope do we use? The rule of thumb is you add 10 degrees to your latitudes. Here in central Missouri, we are at 38.9 degrees latitude. You add 10 to that, and that's 49.8 degrees latitude. Well, for ease of construction, we went with 45 degrees. I mean, we're close enough on that. So we have a 45 degree slope here on our greenhouse. Now, we also have something different. We have a hip side that has a roll-up plastic on it. The reason we have this is that if we want to be able to use this year-round. And when we get into mid to late April and then the summertime, it gets fairly warm in here. We want to be able to get more of the heat out, and that's simply by rolling this up. Now, here in December, we have it shut down. All it takes is just to pull those off and we can roll it up, and we can utilize this all year because since it's facing due south, in the summertime, our sun's almost behind us. So we're not getting as much direct sun into the greenhouse. So it's not as hot sometimes in here as it is even outside. We also want to make sure we have a double layer of plastic. And that's right here. We've turned the electricity off so we don't drown ourselves out. But we've got 2 layers of plastic. It's 6 mil plastic. And this gives us a buffer. We pump air in from the outside into between the sheets of plastic. We want to do outside air because we don't want it to be humid. We don't want it to come from inside the greenhouse, but outside, because we'll get water condensation. But this buffer gives us about 10 more degrees in the wintertime. So we can go from it being 40 to 50 degrees in here at night. So what makes this different is our passive source of heat. We're using these 55-gallon barrels filled with water. Again, we're facing south. They're on the back wall. They heat up during the daytime. We just check the temperature. It's about 85 degrees in here. And at night, when the sun goes down, they release the heat back into the greenhouse. Now, when we talked about this 1-to-2-to-1-to-1 ratio, this is why we didn't want to get too wide, because this heat can only dissipate so far. Now, how much water do we want to use? How many of these barrels do we want to put in? It depends on what you want to do. If you just want to extend the season, that you end it by the first part of December and don't pick it up maybe till March 1st, you want 2.5 gallons of water per every square feet of glazing that you have. So we have a 12 by 24, so that's 288 square feet. So we want about 720 or so gallons of water. Now, if we want to go year round, if we want to be able to use this through the dead of winter, we want to double that to 5 gallons or 1,440 gallons of water. Now, we have 20 55 gallon barrels or 1,100 gallons. So we're 300 gallons short of where we really need to be for the dead of the winter. So we need to add 6 more barrels to make this complete, but we're pretty good. We have not ever frozen in here yet. Here's another aspect of this. Water holds heat, and we can measure this in BTU. So a BTU is increasing water, a pound of water, 1 degree. Since we have 1,100 gallons, we have 9,130 pounds of water. So if this drops 10 degrees, we released 91,300 BTUs into this greenhouse. If it drops 20 degrees, which it did last night, it's 180,000 plus BTUs into this greenhouse. put this in perspective, a typical home heat source has 80 to 100,000 BTUs per hour. So we're putting as much heat into this as you would in about 2 hours straight of running your heater at home. So we are putting a lot of heat back into the greenhouse.